Hey guys, in this science video, we're gonna make some slime. Now, again, with every experiment we do, we always need to be safe. Safety's our number one priority. So as you can see, I have my gloves and I do have my safety goggles on. So the first thing you're gonna need is you're gonna need a bowl to put your stuff into and mix it all up. And you're gonna need Elmer's glue. Now you can use the white glue or the clear glue, it doesn't matter, as long as it's Elmer's glue. So we're gonna take our Elmer's glue and we're just gonna put some into our bowl. Now, actually, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take this top off and pour some in so that it's done easier, because if I squeeze it out, it'll take 20 years and I'll be about 40 by the time that's done. And it looks like we got enough glue in there. Then, as our glue sets, we need to take warm water, okay? And what we're going to use today is a borax solution. Now, there are other things where you can use laundry soap and such, but you're just gonna take about a teaspoon of borax and you put it in your water. Now that needs to dissolve, so we're gonna take our little mixer and we're just gonna mix that up. This is an awfully full glass. I'm actually gonna use the other end just because it's smaller and easier to fit within the cup here. I'm just gonna mix that up so that the borax dissolves in our warm water. When our borax is dissolved in our warm water, we're going to go back to our glue and we're going to just add little bits of warm water and glue together. Now this is where things are going to get a little messy. We got to take it and we got to try to maneuver it around in our glue. Now as you can see, it's still very sticky, so I need to add a little bit more water and a little bit more of the borax solution. So we're going to continue to do this, and it's congealing up or gelling up. And it's not as sticky anymore. I may actually have put a little bit too much water, and it still is sticky, so we're gonna let it mix around in there. And then, you know, slime is usually not this color. I know a lot of you probably watch Nickelodeon and they like the slime people a lot, and that is orange slime and green slime. So we're actually gonna be making some green slime of our own. Now this does need more because I am sticky, and it's okay if you have a little bit of excess water in here, because when this is all done and the slime's all ready to go, you are going to be able to take it out and play with it. So that is not the issue here. The issue here is that I can't open the food coloring with all this slime on my finger, so Miss Jess is going to be very helpful here. Miss Jess, if you could pour, or I'll grab it from here, thank you. I'm gonna put a couple drops of food coloring right onto our slime mixture, right into our water, that's okay. And then this is why it's important to have gloves, because food coloring will stain your hands. So you wanna be able to get in there and mix the slime all up into the green food coloring, or water now. Now, as you can see, our slime mixture that I've made is becoming green.
Jello.
And it will look like Jello, Miss Jess, for a little bit. You gotta add a little bit more. I think what we need in here is actually a little bit more borax to congeal it up. So I'm just gonna put some of that in here. There we go. Yeah, that seems to be working a little bit better. Can you rip me off a piece of paper towel, Miss Jess? Put that right where the bowl is, please. And then we now have our successful green slime. This kind of looks like a weird alien organ, but as you can see, you touch it, play with it, cut it up, and the more you play with it, the more tender it'll get, because at first it's pretty hard and congealy, but you can take it and you can mix it up, smash it, just go around with it. Make it into a disc. You can do a lot of different things with the slime, but there we go. It's kind of like a flubber. Now, if you've never seen the movie Flubber, I recommend watching Flubber. There we go, and there we have it. Some green slime from the experimental lab of Mr. Matt.